Hey guys, my name is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and today I wanted to demonstrate one of our 6x30 jaw crusher modules specifically designed for granite and decorative stone waste. So it starts with the orange hopper behind me. It can be loaded with a tote or bin of scrap material. The hopper vibrates the material at an even rate down into the 6x30 jaw crusher here, which is powered by a diesel motor. Once the material is crushed, it falls down onto this conveyor belt, which can carry the material up and stack it into a pile, a box, or a bin for later use. So let's get this thing fired up and we'll see how it goes. I'm gonna go get some more. So here's the material we crushed. The last couple pieces were some of that man-made quartz. And you can see that crushed it up pretty nice. And we crushed the whole barrel, I don't know, in maybe 5 minutes. So you can see from the video that it really crushes through the stone pretty good. So I wanted to show you guys the startup operation for the diesel. So you turn the key, and once the glow plugs shut off, you can start the diesel. The throttle here can be adjusted in or out for the correct RPM. We found that running about 1500 or 1600 RPM on the tack is just about right, which equates to about 275 to 300 RPM to the jaw crush themselves. And then around here is the clutch mechanism. And so once the RPM is correct on the tack for the diesel motor, you can come around and slowly engage the flywheels on the jaw crusher. And once those start spinning around, you can fully engage the clutch and get full power to the jaw crusher itself. So now let's go around and we'll take a look at the electrical. So this customer wants the unit to be mobile, and also he doesn't have three-phase power at all of his locations. So that's why we have the diesel powering the jaw crusher, but then we have a phase converter here so that he can run single-phase power in and then three-phase power to the motors. And we have three different motors, the conveyor, and then the two vibrating motors, which need three-phase power. And so the phase converter takes care of that. So now let's go take a look at the adjustment to the vibrating hopper. So the vibrating hopper can be adjusted two different ways. There's a fine adjustment here on the phase converter itself. And the volt or the hertz can be adjusted up or down to adjust the vibration of the motor. For a coarser adjustment, you can come back here once the machine is off, take off the covers of the motors here, and you can adjust the weights on the motor shafts themselves to get a coarser adjustment to make it shake harder. When these are wired correctly, the spin is opposite each other, which forces the material towards the jaw crusher. If they're both spinning the same way, the material won't move, so they need to be wired to opposite so that the material gets pushed into the jaw crusher itself. So now we'll go take a look at the jaw crusher maintenance. Now we're looking at the back of the 6x30 jaw crusher, and we can go over some simple things here. There's grease fittings here along the back of the movable jaw and one over there. And greasing about once a day is fine. And when the machine is new, you want to make sure that you build up a bead of grease here, which creates a seal and keeps the dust out. So in the first couple days of operation, make sure that a bead of grease is built up here. It doesn't need to be flinging off the shaft, but that's what creates the seal for the bearings. To adjust the jaw gap, these plates are spacers, which push out the shuttle and the toggle, and conversely drives the jaw plates forward. So to increase the gap, you would take out some of these plates, which would pull all this back and open up the jaw plate. After that's done, this is the tensioning rod. This either needs to be tightened or loosened depending on the adjustment to the jaw plate. If the jaw plate is opened up, this needs to be tightened to keep tension on the whole assembly back here so that it's not flopping around. These bolts here and here keep tension on the plates. And if you are going to add or remove plates, you loosen these bolts, and this large bolt pushes the whole mechanism forward. Then you would back this off a couple turns so you could pull these plates out. So that's in a nutshell how you adjust the jaw gap and the easy maintenance on the 6x30 jaw crusher. The conveyor maintenance is pretty easy. There's 6 bearings on the unit. There's 2 here on the idler pulley, 2 on the tail pulley, and 2 on the head pulley. And the one other thing you want to keep an eye on is the gearbox. There's a little sight glass on the far side for the oil level. So just make sure the gearbox has oil and there's no weeps or leaks out of the gearbox. So I hope you guys enjoyed a video of our 6x30 jaw crusher module. If you have any questions or comments, you can give us a call or send us an email, all of which is in the description below. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.